The servant said to him, "Do you want us then to go and gather them up?" But he said, "No, that's why you gather up the tears. You also uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest, and at the time of harvest, I will say to the reaper, first gather together the tears and bind them in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barns." May the Lord bless the reading of the words in the mighty name of Jesus. This is a popular passage that we all know, I believe. The Bible said the farmer sowed a good seed. Verse 25 says, when men slept, the enemy came. When men slept, the enemy came. I mean, that's one thing you should realize from that statement. And that the fact that there are enemies. The enemy is always there. The enemy is always there looking for opportunity to be planted. Looking for opportunity to launch his attack. Looking for opportunity to sow a seed in the life of people, believers and unbelievers alike. The Bible says when men slept, the enemy came. The enemy came. Let's turn our Bible to 1 Peter 5:8. First Peter 5, verse 8. Be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. Another translation says, beware balance. Be temperate. Be sober of mind. Be cautious at all times. I love that translation. Be cautious at all times, even when you are sleeping. For that enemy of yours, the devil, roam around like a lion, roaring around in fierce hunger, seeking someone to seize upon and devour. The Bible says, be well balanced. Be cautious at all times. At all times. In the day and in the night. In the morning and in the afternoon. When you have money and when you don't have money, be cautious. Be mindful that there is someone, that is the devil, that is seeking for somebody to devour. There is somebody that is watching out. Is watching out for that unguided hours in my life, in your life, in your family. The Bible says it's roaring. It's going around in a fierce hunger. It's hungry. It's hungry. And it's looking for where to feed on. When men slept, the enemy came. And I want to announce to you that Satan has been doing that since ages. And he has not stopped. Brothers and sisters, Satan has not stopped. He did that with our forefathers. He did that with Abraham. With Adam and Eve. He started with them and he has not stopped it today. He has not stopped it today. When you look at Genesis chapter 3, we see there that the serpent was more cunning. Satan is more cunning. He's more crafty. Above all beasts of the field. He went to the woman as God said. As God said, you should not eat any of this fruit. We were made perfect. We were made flawless. We were made without error. We were made in the image of God. We were made in the likeness of God. We were made without any fault. You were made without any fault, brothers. You were made without any flaws. Perfect in the image of God. In the likeness of God. You were made without sickness, brothers. You were made without disease. You were made without any form of infirmities. Do you know that malaria was not made with you? When you were made, cancer was not there. Diabetes was not there. Leukemia was not there. You were made perfect. You were made in the image of God, in the likeness of God. But the Bible says, when men slept, the enemy came. He came to Adam and Eve. He sowed in them disobedience. He sowed in them rebellion. He sowed in them sin. And eventually, the ultimate is so dead. He sowed death into their life. He sowed discomfort. Of course, the wages of sin is death. Brothers and sisters, God is encouraging all of us this morning. They need to be alive. They need to be awake. They need to be on our guard. They need to watch. They need to be watchful. They need to know that there is somebody who is looking for opportunity to attack your life. There is someone who is looking for opportunity to launch its attack against your family. Brothers, you can't afford to fold your hands. You can't afford to say, well, all is well. I don't need to pray. That would be a great mistake, brothers. But I say, when men slept, the enemy came. Enemy came. And he has not stopped. We have nine days. God made them all, the night, the day. God made them for different purpose. But we should know that Satan has hijacked. Satan has hijacked the night, and they carry out most of the activities in the night. Most of the activities, they carried it out in the night. And that's why the Bible says, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 5 and to 7. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, 5 to 7. I want you all to read that. First Thessalonians chapter 5, 5 to 7. I read from Amplified Bible. Say, you are sons of the light and sons of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep. Let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober. For those who sleep, they sleep at night. And those who get drunk, got drunk at night. Another translation says, be wide awake. Be alert. Be watchful. Be cautious. Be on your guard. They say, be watchful. Somebody who is watchful will not sleep when others are sleeping. If you are watching over somebody, you don't sleep anyhow. You don't eat anyhow. You don't just go out anyhow. Why? Because you are watchful. Because you know that there is somebody looking for that hour when you will not be watching. That Satan who is watching over, you might say, like a roaring lion, and is going about from your family to his family, to that family, to that individual, is looking for opportunity. Is looking for opportunity. The Bible says, he's seeking out in a fierce hunger. And in the book of Ephesians, the Bible says, awake, you who sleep, arise from the dead. Awake, you who sleep, arise from the dead. Brothers, sisters, I believe this period is not the period for sleeping. It's not the period for sleeping. It's not the period for careless living. It's not the period for careless way of life. It's not the period we should take our Christian life with levity. No, brothers and sisters. The Bible says, awake. 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 You can't afford to force your hands when there is fire on the mountain. When the roof is on the fire, you can't afford to sleep at that time. You can't. And brothers and sisters, I think this is the kind of posture that God will want us to have at this time around. Why? Because enemy is on the rampage. Satan is not resting. Why I'm resting, Satan is not resting. He's going about. He's going about. He's going about. From one place to the other, Satan is running around. So be careful how you live. That's another translation. Say, be careful how you live your life. Don't live like fools. That's the translation. Be careful how you live. Don't live like fools, but be like those who are wise. Be careful the way you live. But I say, don't live like fools. A fool will see trouble and still go ahead. That's a fool. He sees trouble yet, he goes ahead. That's a fool. A man will be a fool if he does not see that there is something that is going on in the realm of the spirit. Even as a member of FMI, we should understand that God wants every one of us to do what? To wake up. God wants us to do what? To wake up. That the message God is bringing to us. Say, wake up. Don't live like fools. You can't afford to live the way you were living before, when there was no war, when everything is okay. But we must understand that there are wars. War to fight, battle to fight. But thank God you are born to win your battles. And you shall win your battles in the mighty name of Jesus. But the fact remains that you will have to fight it. That's the truth. You can't excuse yourself from the battle of life. And the book of Joel 3:9. If it can be projected, let's read it. Joel 3:9. Let I read from here. Proclaim this among the nations. Prepare for war. Wake up the mighty men. Let all the men of war draw near. Let them come up. Prepare for war. Brothers, we are in the battlefield. As soldiers of Christ, and we cannot afford to sleep when the war is still raging. We can't go to sleep when the roof is on fire. No, we cannot. When it seems as if Satan is gaining ground every day, every day, every day. And the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 52, it said, awake, awake, put on your strength, O Zion. Put on your beautiful garment, O Jerusalem, the holy city. For the uncircumcised and the unclean shall no longer come to you. You might say, shake up yourself if you are sleeping. Shake up yourself. Shake up yourself. If you are dozing, shake up yourself. If you are not active, shake up yourself. If you are getting tired, shake up yourself. If you are getting discouraged, shake up yourself. This is not the time for us to be discouraged, brothers and sisters. The Bible says, when men slept, Satan came, the enemy came. And we emphasize the fact that he has not stopped visiting the families. But I believe God that each time he visits your family, He shall meet you awake and fervent in the mighty name of Jesus. Because somebody may say, don't we sleep? Won't we sleep again? No, nobody says you should not sleep. In fact, that would be against medical advice. And that would be contrary even to the Bible. God expects us to sleep. Walk in the day, sleep in the night, you rest your body. But what we are saying is, even in your sleep, even when you are sleeping, you are awake in the spirit. When you are sleeping, you are still conscious. Nobody will sleep the sleep of death in Jesus' name. Because one thing I know that when our spirit is alive and is active, even when you are sleeping, something appears. Right there in the dream, you know what to do. It's easy for you to know what to do. But if you sleep, spirit, soul, and body, I mean, that is not what we are talking about this morning. So nobody is saying you should not sleep. You can sleep. Whether 6 hours, whether 8 hours, you can sleep. But brothers and sisters, when you sleep physically, don't sleep spiritually. Because spiritual slumbering is worse than physical slumbering. When your spirit is cold and you are lifeless in the realm of the spirit, this is the time Satan is actually looking for. The Bible says, when man slept, the enemy came. When is that time? When is that time? When is the time Satan is looking for? Satan is looking for that hour, for that moment. When you become weak in your prayer life, you become weak in studying the Bible, you become weak in receiving from God, you become weak in your dedication, you become weak in your consecration, you become weak in your aggression, in the realm of the spirit. This is the time Satan is always looking for. You become weak when those things that you don't go near, maybe 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, when you nearly gave your life to the Lord, when those things are becoming, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter now. It doesn't matter now. It doesn't matter. That is the time you are sleeping. You are sleeping. You have been taking maybe 1 hour to pray in the Holy Ghost before, but now you have reduced it to 30 minutes. That is the time you are sleeping. You are sleeping. You have been taking a day to fast in a week before, and now it has become once in 2 weeks. That is the time you are sleeping. Or maybe regularly before, at least in a week, you will take some time to pray in the night, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours, but today, you are brought in wisdom and you must observe 7 days a week, 8 hours sleep. That is the time Satan is looking out for. And that the time Satan normally strives, when you are weak, when you are embracing sin, that the time Satan is looking out for. When you are comfortable with sinner friends, not because you want to witness to them, but you are comfortable with them, and you have forgotten all the doctrine of oaths that break off with them. What does the altar of God has with the altar of Belial? And you are becoming yoked with unbelievers against the scriptures. That is the time you are sleeping. And that is the time Satan is always looking out for. But God says, wake up from your slumber. Say, wake up. I pray that God Almighty, we encourage every heart this day in the mighty name of Jesus. In the Song of Solomon chapter 5, verse 2a, I saw something there, it interests me. Solomon said, I sleep, but my heart is awake. Song of Solomon chapter 5, verse 2, said, I sleep, but my heart is awake. That's a man who does not sleep the sleep of death. Said, I sleep. In other words, physically, I sleep. Bodily, I sleep. But he said, my heart is awake. My heart is awake. So when you sleep, it takes a man who is not sleeping with everything to be able to fight even in the night. And brothers and sisters, you have said the parable, the Bible says, when men sleep, it is in the night that enemy launches attack. What do they do? When they come, here we saw something good was planted, but Satan came and saw something bad. And that has not stopped. Many people, when they give you, when they tell you the origin, the beginning of a particular problem, they will say, ah, I just slept too. And it seems as if mosquito bite me. And in the morning, I saw little swelling. And before you know it, become incurable problem. Incurable. So when they come, what do? They sow tears. They sow sickness. They sow disease. They sow the infirmity. To some, they sow cancer. They sow diabetes. They sow leukemia. That's what they do. They carry out satanic ministry of killing, of stealing, and of destroying. That's what Satan does. He has not stopped in those threefold ministry. He has done it before and is still doing it again and again and again and again and again. And so, brothers and sisters, the Bible says, be sober, be serious, be cautious at all times. Even when you are celebrating, brothers and sisters, ask, even when you are celebrating, be cautious. Even when you are at a party, be cautious. Be cautious of who you are, be cautious of what you have, be cautious of the position you occupy. At a party, even when you are dancing, don't dance away your mind. Because sometimes, I mean, these are seasons, these are periods, these are opportunities that Satan always look out for. When you are flanging your agbada and you are dancing, as a Christian, don't dance away who you are. You can't afford to do, I mean, the Bible said, do not sleep like what? Like others do. Civilians can afford to do that. They can afford to do that. They can afford to do anything, but you cannot. You cannot. A good soldier will not do that. Even when a good soldier sleeps, you see them putting their gun behind their tank. In other words, they are at alert, ready to shoot, ready to, and they are sleeping, they are closing one eye, the other eye is opened. I mean, that's what God expects us to do, brothers and sisters. I pray that none of us will be victim in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Well, the second part will be at another day. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, when men slept, enemy came. That's the basis of our prayer this morning. That's the basis of our prayer this morning. So I want us to stand up. We want to take the rest few minutes to just pray. Open your Bible to Psalm 13. We sum that. Psalm 13, verses 3 and 4. I want us to read it together. Psalm 13, verses 3 and 4. Are we there, please? Let's read it together. Consider and hear me, O Lord my God. Enlighten my eye, lest I sleep the sleep of death. Lest my enemy say, I have prevailed against him. Let those who trouble me rejoice when I am moved. I want to say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, that day I come unto you and I pray, I will not sleep the sleep of death. I will not sleep the sleep of death. I want to open your mouth and pray. The psalmist said, "Less my enemies say I have prevailed, I shall not sleep the sleep of death. I shall not sleep the sleep of death. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, I shall not sleep the sleep of death. Mi o ne sunrun ku. Mi o ne sun orun iku loruko Jesu. I shall not sleep the sleep of death. In Jesus' name we pray. The psalmist said, lest my enemy say, I have prevailed against him. Enemy will not prevail against you. I want to open your mouth and pray, oh God, in the name of Jesus, I pray this day, enemy will not prevail against my life, against my home, against my family, against my children, against my wife. Open your mouth and pray, brothers. Enemy will not prevail. Satan will not prevail against me. They will not prevail against my home. They will not prevail against my church. They will not prevail against my wife in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Finally, because of our time, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every seed that is not of God, planted into my life, planted into my family, by the power of God and the fire of the Holy Ghost, let them be uprooted. Let them be uprooted. You know the seed that has been sowed into your life. The seed of cancer. The seed of diabetes, the seed of sickness. Oh God, I pray, whatever seed planted into my body, planted into my life, I uproot them by the power of God. Resekede bababo. Lembro sekede bakoga. Leba koda baba baba baba. Lembra so kodeke lede baba. Regegegege. Every foot seed, I command you to die. Every foot seed, I command to die. Every foot seed, every foot seed, every foot seed. And the life of your children, I command them to die. I command them to die. Every foot seed in my body, in my family, in the body of my wife, in the body of my children. Oh God, let them die. 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 In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty God. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please, as I was praying, there's somebody, you have a report that scares you in a way. God said what you should do is that you take that report. You take it to God, like that King Jehoshaphat done. Take it to God. If you want to weep before God, if you want to cry, cry before God. And that God will turn the situation around. I don't know the kind of report, maybe medical report, but I don't know. But you have that report and you get scared. You get scared. But that is what God said I should tell you. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Let's put our hand together for the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Please, the following people, I would like to see them after service. Mrs. Olagundoye, Mrs. Oluwaloshe, Pastor Oluwaloshe, Evangelist Owolabi Tejumola, Nkechi Clement, Kespo, Mrs. Oladokun, Pastor Mrs. Oluloyo, Deacon Leke Ayashiji, Mrs. Amaya, and Mrs. Oni. So please, I would like to see us immediately. Praise the Lord. So don't forget tomorrow. So when you are coming, come with 3 stones.